Hi everyone, Eva here. I'm the owner and founder of My Sleeping Baby, and today is Sleep Tip Tuesday. We're going to continue with our discussion last week on some of the biggest mistakes that families make when they're attempting to implement a sleep plan for their baby or child. This week, we're going to talk all about inconsistency. So I know I've talked about this at length in the group, but I really do want to delve into a little bit more detail as to what I mean when I say inconsistency and what it can mean for your successes when you're trying to make some changes. So generally speaking, I always tell people that when you're implementing a plan, you want to remain 100% consistent so that your baby is getting a very clear message as to what's going on. So if you are constantly starting and stopping the process or switching things up every few days and trying something new, you're gonna get a very confused baby on your hands because there's no clear message. And as a result, if you have a baby that's confused, you're likely going to get a lot more crying, a lot more protesting, and not nearly as much sleeping as you'd like. So here are two very common examples of inconsistency that you want to avoid. One example is something called intermittent reinforcement. Intermittent reinforcement is when you have a baby who cries and cries and cries for really any period of time, and then at a certain point, you give in and change things up and ultimately give the baby what he or she wants, whether that means you pick them up and rock them to sleep, or you feed them, or you pat them, or you pull your chair closer to them. You see, here's the problem, and I want to explain the problem by using an example from a non-sleep scenario. Let's say that you have a three-year-old who is asking you for a cookie, and you say, no, I'm sorry, buddy, it's not time for dessert. And then he decides to throw a temper tantrum because he wants a cookie. And he's crying and screaming and crying and screaming. And then eventually you say, oh my God, I have a splitting headache. Here, have a cookie. Fine, just, you know, whatever you need to do, just stop crying. The problem, the obvious problem with this scenario is that the three-year-old has learned to tantrum in order to get what he wants. And he's learned that crying and screaming is worth his while. And so next time he asks you for a cookie or for anything for that matter, and you say no, there's a very good chance that he is going to try throwing another temper tantrum to get what he wants because it worked last time. So why won't it work again this time? And you see, with sleep, it's no different. The last thing that we want to be doing is encouraging more crying by rewarding it. So our goal here ultimately is to minimize the protesting as much as possible. Look, some protesting is unavoidable, but if we are rewarding the crying and rewarding the protesting, we're going to get more of it. So if the goal is to minimize things, you need to remain 100% consistent and avoid any kind of intermittent reinforcement. The other very common example of inconsistency that I see is when families respond to the child inconsistently throughout the night. So they might respond to him one way at 10 p.m. and then another way at 2 a.m. So for example, he wakes up at 10 o'clock and the family remains consistent. They're, you know, checking on him as per their plan, or they're sitting in the chair as per their plan, and then the baby goes back to sleep and then wakes up, let's say, a few hours later at 2 o'clock in the morning, and then the family just goes and rocks him back to sleep. The problem with that scenario is that once again, the baby is getting very inconsistent messaging and doesn't understand why he's expected to fall asleep on his own at 10 p.m., but gets rocked to sleep at 2 o'clock in the morning. And then once again, we have a confused baby. And confused babies are going to cry louder and harder than we would like. And there's a very good chance that your efforts are going to get thwarted without this consistent messaging across the board. So I know that it's exhausting when you're in the thick of implementing this plan, but remember that this is short-term pain for long-term gain. Now, some of you might be watching this video convinced that their baby or child is an alien incapable of giving you good quality sleep. So here's the good news. As long as your child is healthy, don't underestimate what he or she can do. It might be a little bit more challenging if your baby is more high needs or whatnot, but as long as you have a sleep plan that's addressing the various roots of the problem. And as long as you are 100% consistent implementing that plan, you too can get yourself good quality sleep. And I can say this confidently, having worked with over 600 babies at this point, I can pretty much guarantee that your baby is not an alien and is capable of giving you much better sleep than what you're getting right now. I hope this was helpful for everyone. Have a wonderful day.